Session 3-5, Quran, the last scripture of Allah, by ex-Brigadier Mustan Sarbillah. Brothers and sisters, Assalamu Alaikum. We meet after a month of Ramzan, and I consider it important to inform you that from tomorrow onwards, we are going to start a session on in Urdu on Sunnah Zinda, Ummah Zinda. So it will be on alternative days. One day it will be Quran, the last scripture of Allah, and on the second day it will be Sunnah Zinda, Ummah Zinda. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. With the name of Allah, who is most gracious and tremendously merciful. Namadu nusalli ala rasulihil kareem, and blessings on Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the last and the final prophet. Surah 45, Al-Jasiyah, verse 26. Qul lillahu yuhyikum, summa yumitukum, summa yajma'ukum, ila yawmil qiyamati la rayba fih, walakinna aksara an-nas la ya'lamun. You say, it is God alone who has shaped you first, created you, given you life, then He'll make you dead, and then gather you on the doomsday beyond a shadow of doubt, inevitably, and then gather you on the doomsday beyond a shadow of doubt, inevitably. But a majority of people do not register it. Brothers and sisters, we continue with Al-Nisa and with part 5. Today we'll begin with verse 140, and we shall cover verse 140 to first begin with part 5 and finish on verse 155. First, verse 140. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَقَدْ نَزَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا بِحَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلُهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَامِعُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْكَافِرِينَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ جَمِيعًا. 140 translation. And he has already revealed to you in this book that when you hear Allah's revelations being denied or ridiculed, you should not sit with them unless they shift to another subject, failing which you shall be considered guilty like them by Allah. Surely Allah will gather the hypocrites and the disbelievers all together in hell. 141. Allazina yatarabbasuna bikum fa in kana lakum fatum min Allah qalu alam nakun ma'akum in kana lil kafirin nasibum qalu alam tahwiz alaykum wa namnaakum min al mu'minin fallahu yahkumu bayna yawm al qiyamah. وَلَنْ تَعْجَى لَلَّهُ لِلْكَافِرِينَ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَبِيلًا. 141 translation. These hypocrites wait and watch to see how the wind blows. If Allah grants you victory, they say, we are with you. And if the disbelievers gain success, they will say to them, we were not strong enough to fight against you. Yet We protected you from the Muslims. Allah will judge between you and them on the day of resurrection. Allah will not leave the way for the disbelievers to triumph over the believers. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاءُونَ النَّاسَ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. 142. Surely the hypocrites try to deceive Allah, whereas in fact He has reversed their deception on them. They are not going to be rewarded. When they stand up for salah, prayers, they stand reluctantly, merely to be seen by the people, and do not remember Allah but little. Muzabina bana zalika la ilaha wala wala ilaha wala wa man yuzlillahu falan tajida lahu sabila. 143. Hanging between the two, neither towards this nor towards that, and who is misguided by Allah and who is misguided by Allah, you will not find for him any way to success. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu la tattakhizul kafirina awliya min dunillahil mu'minin aturiduna an taj'alu lillahi alaykum sultanan mubina. 144. O believers, do not take the disbelievers as your protecting friends against the interest of the faithful believers. Do you want to earn the blatant vengeance of Allah by taking the disbelievers as friends? Inna al-munafiqina fi darki al-asfali min an-nar wa lan tajida lahum nasira. 145. Surely the hypocrites are in the lowest depth of the fire of hell, and you will definitely not find any helper for them. Illazina tabu wa aslahu wa tasamu billahi wa akhlasu dinahum lillahi fa ulaika ma'al mu'minin wa sawfa yutillahu al-mu'minina ajran azima. 146. However, those who repent, seek forgiveness from Allah, and mend their ways, and hold fast to Allah, and remain totally obedient to Allah, they'll be considered to be the believers, and soon Allah will give the believers a great reward. Ma yafalu Allah bi azabikum in shakartum wa amantum wa kana Allah shakirin alima. 147. The last verse of part 5. Why should Allah punish you if you are submissive, grateful, and a real believer? Why should Allah punish you if you are submissive, grateful, and a real believer? Allah values the grateful and knows everything absolutely well. Now, beginning with part 6, verse 148 of Surah Nisa, the first surah which continues, لا يحب الله الجهر بسوء من القول إلا من ظلم إنما ظلم وكان الله سميعا عليما. 148. Allah doesn't like evil words to be uttered except by someone who is truly wronged, and Allah hears all and knows all. إن تبدو خيرم أو تخفوه أو تعفو عن سوء فإن الله كان عفوا قديرا. 149. And if you do some good pious deeds in public view, openly, or do them privately, or you overlook, disregard, forgive an evil deed, so Allah too is all forgiving, all powerful. He'll also forgive the concerned individual or individuals, and may multiply your reward thereafter. You will surely be rewarded if you have done so for the pleasure of Allah alone. You will surely be rewarded, I repeat, if you have done so for the pleasure of Allah alone. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن يُفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَيَقُولُونَ نُؤْمِنُ بِبَعْضٍ وَنَكْفُرُ بِبَعْضٍ وَيُرِيدُونَ أَن تَتَّخِذُوا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ سَبِيلًا 150. The people who disbelieve Allah and His messengers and want to draw a line between Allah and His messengers, saying, "We believe in some and reject others, the rest." They desire to take a midway. They actually want to have another religion between Islam and Islam believing and kufr, that is disbelieving. They actually want to have another religion between Islam believing and kufr, disbelieving. Ulaika humul kafiruna haqqan wa atadna lil kafirina azaban muhina. 151. Such are the disbelievers in reality, and we have prepared for the disbelievers a humiliating, torturous punishment. والذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ولم يفرقوا بين أحد منهم أولئك سوف يؤتيهم أجورهم كان الله غفور رحيما. 152. And those who have come to believe in Allah and all His prophets and do not discriminate between any of them, we shall reward them soon. And Allah is most forgiving, most merciful. Yasaluka ahalul kitabi an tunazzila alayhim kitabam min as-samaa'i faqad saalu Musa akbara min zalika faqalu arana Allah jahratan fa akhazatum sa'iqatu bi zulmihim summa takhazul ijla min ba'd ma ja'atuhum mul bayyinatu wa afawna an ذَلِكَ وَآتَيْنَا مُوسَى سُلْطَانًا مُبِينًا 153. The people of the book ask you to bring down from the heavens a written scripture. Such demands are nothing new, not surprising, because the Israelites, that is the Jews, have been behaving likewise earlier too. So they have been demanding from Moses, Musa, even harder things, miracles. They asked him, "Make us see Allah right in front of us with our own eyes." So a thunderbolt struck them because of their wickedness. Subsequently, the Israelites, in spite of getting numerous signs, indications from Allah as regards the right path, they made a Kaaba their God and began prostrating before it for a month. As a punishment from Allah, 70,000 people were beheaded by those in the community who used to ask them to refrain from this shirk. Then we also forgive them this shirk, pantheism, and gave Musa, Moses, and his followers a clear superiority, sovereignty. وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَهُمُ الطُّورَ بِمِيثَاقِهِمْ وَقُلْنَا لَهُمْ ادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُلْنَا لَهُمْ لَا تَعْدُوا فِي السَّبْتِ وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. 154. Thereafter, when the Israelites complained to Prophet Moses, Musa, that the orders, injunctions of Torah were harsh, difficult to obey, we lifted Mount Tur to hang over their heads and took the covenant from them that they'll obey our commandments. On another occasion, we ordered them to enter the gates, prostrating in humility. And yet, on another occasion, subsequently, we ordered them not to exceed the limits in fishing on Saturdays, and took a solemn commitment from them. Fima naqsihim misaqahum wa kufrihim bi ayatillahi wa qatlihim al-anbiya bighayr bihaq wa qawlihim qulubuna ghulfun bal taba'a Allahu 'alayha bi kufrihim wa la yu'minuna illa qalila. The last verse today, 155. So they met their fate. The punishment they got was for breaking their promises, commitments, disobeying the orders of Allah, and repeated bloodletting of the prophets very unjustly. And because they used to say that our hearts are sealed with righteousness, we need no new guidance. Not at all. Actually, Allah has sealed their hearts because of their constant prolonged disobedience. So only a few have believed. That's all for today. Jazakallah. Next session would be in Urdu, inshallah, tomorrow. That is Sunnah Zinda, Ummat Zinda. Jazakallah.